So in my last video, I asked you guys if you wanted to know more Bleach news, whether it be small or big, and you guys just want to eat it up anyway. So here's some small kind of tidbit news that I feel is video worthy for you. Now, of course, I think we have a production committee member that has been under our noses for quite a while. But before I get into that, I do want to jump into talking about Jumperty Heroes, which is a Shueisha specific game where it has a collaboration of all Shonen Jump characters in one little gacha game. Is it good? It's alright, I played a little bit of it, but this is the first time we're going to see Thousand Year Blood War characters that we haven't seen in Bleach Brave Souls actually get implemented into this game, and it seems like they're doing a big promotion with it. And as I said, it's important because it is a specifically Shueisha game online. So with that being said, I do believe now is the time that we're going to start seeing more marketing being pushed towards Bleach around about this time of the year, since we're having a whole massive event on Jumperty Heroes, again seeing characters that we haven't seen in BBS yet. Which, in saying that, I have heard apparent quote-unquote leaks from someone saying that apparently K-Lab has the license to Thousand Year Blood War characters again. And if that is in fact true, because it's not from a normal source that I personally know from, if that is in fact true and they do have the rights again, in quotation, because they never really lost the rights, they were just under agreement not to release these characters for a certain amount of time, it would make sense, seeing as, you know, the development team usually take about 6 months of planning and making before they actually make a public release to the game. So I was told from one of the K-Lab staff back in 2017/18. So if that is the case and they do get it back in December, it makes perfect sense that in 6 months time, when they start releasing Thousand Year Blood War banners again for the gacha game Bleach Brave Souls, and if this is the case, this would fall into conjunction with a summer/fall release. And this makes sense because of the marketing that you can have possibly within the anime's breaks. So obviously, Bleach has its episode, goes into a 15-minute break, shows Bleach Brave Souls for promotion, and then so on and so forth. And they'll have, you know, Bleach Brave Souls characters from the Thousand Year Blood War arc to promote. So it's interesting to follow the game news as well as the anime news, because they are in part conjunction within themselves. So, interesting things. Next on the list, I did this week or last week actually post a new Jump magazine scan for Bleach, and it's not a particularly good scan because it is black and white. If it's in colour, it means it's significant. If it's in black and white, it usually means that it's very unimportant, but it's there anyway. That's usually how the Jump magazine formula goes. With that being said though, the interesting thing so much is not so much the contents of the page, but however, the interesting sponsors in regarding the Bleach expedition. And these sponsors are Iris Oyama, Culture Entertainment, K-Lab, and Lawson Entertainment. Now, Lawson was involved in sponsoring Bleach back in the day. There's some interesting merchandising regarding to that and exclusivities at their supermarkets. So it's good to see Lawson back on track and getting involved. And the other two, I can't really say I know very well. However, I found it extremely interesting, and maybe this is from my perspective, and if anyone in the comment section down below, I would like you guys to comment. Please fill me in if any exhibit has actually displayed, one, not this amount of push and marketing, but two, the amount of sponsors and people involved within this as well. And I'll get about that on in a bit and my thoughts and speculation in regarding to that. But I've never really seen a art exhibit really have sponsors before, and that's a bit alienated to me. As well as the amount of PVs, like, yeah, I've maybe seen one PV, maybe for My Hero and maybe for Demon Slayer. But again, that's really just usually a one-off. And the amount of pushing within the magazine itself is way more than I've ever seen with any other series. And this really tells me you don't really do that much pushing without some sort of validity or reason to do other than, hey, here's an art exhibit, fans can go see their favourite stuff and then get out. And in fact, the same date is at the same date as Jump Festa too, which really is perplexing. And there's usually two scenarios to that. But to get back onto the sponsors, the real thing that interests me the most is that K-Lab are getting involved within the exhibit itself. And why this is important, and I think I believe I said this back in 2017, Bleach Brave Souls was one of the main ultimatums to having Bleach return. It's successful, it was only supposed to go up to the Fullbring arc, it was so successful that it went into the Thousand Year Blood War arc content. We had the first 14 characters of the Thousand Year Blood War arc to see what the reception would have been like for Shueisha, and the fact that it did really well went beyond round 4 and went beyond those first 14 characters. So it was a massive deciding factor on whether Bleach was going to continue or not. But also, there's some really interesting things with K-Lab that I think we're really underestimating here. The fact that they're getting involved in the exhibit, it must mean, you know, there's going to be some promotion for K-Lab themselves. Maybe with the art book, I'm not quite sure. That could be the reason, and that could be the only reason. Who knows? But to sponsor and put their money into this exhibit to do well shows to me that there's going to be more than just the maybe casual art exhibit. And why is this important? Well, actually, back in 2020, there was a really interesting article talking about an actual merger between K-Lab and Studio Pierrot. It was announced on April 24th that the anime Studio Pierrot, known for producing Bleach and Naruto TV anime series alongside popular anime and mobile game developer K-Lab, who worked with Pierrot on Bleach Brave Souls and Yu Yu Hakusho and 100% Meiji Battle, I've never heard of that one personally, have formed a strategic business alliance between the two companies to further develop their collaboration and continue to aim to create content that can be enjoyed by fans around the world. In a post on K-Lab's website, the video game company said that more video content from Pierrot will be developed into mobile games and used for various merchandise and events. Now that's interesting, right? Because Pierrot is a anime studio, right? They make anime. They don't really do anything other than that and maybe some merchandise and etc. etc. However, the interesting thing here is that, well, we've had two openings for BBS in the past, and you know, this was before 2020. So are we gonna get another video game opening potentially? I mean, what could K-Lab use for animation in their game besides an opening to in-game or maybe character designs? But then again, K-Lab already have their own character designers, and this is where it gets interesting. K-Lab have actually anime produced and directed and also been involved in a production committee, granted on some series that they've put funding into, but there has been one, and it's quite recent, which K-Lab have actually produced an anime, and that is the series that you are seeing on your screen right now. And to be honest, even though this is the only kind of anime that they produced, the other animes that they've been involved in hasn't been too bad in animation either. So this does give me a good track record and actually some really good confidence towards Bleach's anime. Seeing as that if they are involved on the production committee for Bleach, which, do you know what, I have no shadow of doubt that is pretty much a possibility, a big possibility. It means that money and funding and also people that play Bleach Brave Souls, that contribution has also already gone onto the anime itself. So it seems like we have a big fish within the production committee. It seems like it is the case, since as they are getting involved with Pierrot in terms of stuff for Bleach, even if it's their mobile game, they're still putting in the money into Studio Pierrot for the Bleach IP, which is fantastic. Again, if you want to look at the anime on your screen right now, it looks gorgeous. And to be honest with you, I generally think whatever money is being put into this, because we already know some big money has been put into the Bleach IP, and within the creation of the new arc itself, adding another big fish into this pond is going to make it look even better and also give us some good merchandising and some good advertisements, not only for Bleach Brave Souls, but also for the Bleach anime as a whole. But I guess the big question here, especially, is Jump Festa, which has probably been the reason why I've off-put this video for so long. Is Bleach going to have a trailer, or is it going to have a key visual at Jump Festa? And here's my thoughts, right? This isn't a leak or anything that I've heard from inside. This is just my thoughts, because it's very difficult to talk about because there's not really any clear-cut information, and maybe we'll get that in a few weeks. Jump Festa has a secret stage that they announced this week. However, I do generally believe it's Spy X Family, even though it has just recently had a PV. It could be Spy X Family, it could be Undead Unlock, it could be Mashal, for example, it could be even Chainsaw Man. I don't think this is Bleach related, and unless there's a stage that gets announced between now and the early starts of December, I don't think Bleach is going to have a stage. And that's a bit weird, but when you think about it, the amount of promotion, the amount of marketing, the amount of special tickets you can get, there's even like a thing like where the studio audience can go watch Kubo do a drawing. I generally think that with this heavy promotion, I think that instead of Jump Festa, the Bleach exhibit, which is happening on the same day that Jump Festa is going to be its own event and its own expo besides Jump Festa. And I don't know whether I like that or not, but I see massive potential in it, and it makes sense to me because, again, as I said, I've never seen so much marketing and promotion going into this, especially the extra things such as an opening, getting an actual like artist and band to do an opening for this exhibit. I think there's more. And what kind of sells this for me in a sense is Nagatoro-san actually got a second season announcement at its own event/expo. So it's not really off the table. Am I sold on it? I don't know. Do I want it? Well, I always enjoy Jump Festival. It's always like the E3 of the consoles, right, and video games. I would generally like to watch Jump Festa along with other series and experience it online. But if it's at the Bleach Expo, it makes more sense. I just want to know what Bleach's appearance is going to be at Jump Festa, because again, there's always merchandise, etc. So, and again, Burn the Witch. Is Burn the Witch also going to be a part of the Bleach Expo as well? We don't know. So again, that's my thoughts as it stands right now. And will we be able to watch it or experience the expo? Probably not. However, I'm pretty sure we'll hear something if something cracks down anyway. That's just my thoughts and opinions. What do you guys think in the comment section down below? Do you prefer it being at Jump Festa, or do you prefer it to be at the expo? Of course, hit that subscribe button, because it really does help me out as per usual. And yeah, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.